Hello dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel Science GK Facts. In the previous video, we have already studied what is electric current, what is the SI unit of electric current, what is charge and what is the SI unit of charge, and we have defined what is electric current also there. What is electric current? It is the amount of charge flowing through a particular area of a given metallic conductor in unit time, right? This is how we have defined, and we had also written in the form of an equation. That is I is equal to Q by T. This is all about electric current. When numerical problems are asked based on this, how to solve them? That we are going to learn in this video now. See, first coming to the numerical problems, let us take one example here. When you read the example, you should be able to understand. Means what? Example it may be, that problem, given problem it may be. When you read the problem, you should be able to understand what is given first and what is asked. Once if you are able to identify this, you can easily calculate there. First you see, a current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. Okay. Now you see, when you read this, what is given? A current of, current means I, they have given, right? So let us write that one here. Current. So, before solving, you need to write what given, isn't it? Given is what? Current. Current is given, that is I is equal to 0.5 ampere, it is given. Next, what is given? Read the problem. Next, again, electric bulb. See, drawn by a filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. Minutes means what time? Okay, time is also given. Just let us write here, time. Time. T is how much? It is 10 minutes. Okay. Now, then next what it is given? See, current is given, time is given. Next you see, find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. Find means what? We are supposed to calculate this. What we have to calculate? Find the amount of charge means what? Charge, how do we denote? Charge is denoted by Q or not. So that Q we are supposed to calculate here. Then let us write that also. What is that? Charge Q is equal to how much? Coulomb. What is the SI unit of charge? That is coulomb, right? We don't know how much, so question mark I have put there. Now let us take the formula, that is current. It is denoted by like this, current I is equal to charge, amount of charge flowing in unit time through a particular area of a conductor, right? Q by T. So Q by T. Now what we have to calculate? Q we have to calculate. So let us exchange this water terms here. Keep Q one side. Next you bring T to the other side. This becomes what? I into T. Right? Now you see I into T. One thing we have to keep in the mind, when time is given or some of the things are given, like that length, time, when they are given, they have to be converted to first SI units, okay, before calculations. Now you see, here time is given in minutes. What is the SI unit of time? It is second, right? So we have to convert this minutes into seconds. Now you see, 10 minutes is given. For 1 minute, how many seconds? 60 seconds, right? Then 10 minutes means what? 600 seconds or not? So if you convert it to SI unit, 600 seconds we are getting, right? This is what given, this is formula. Now let us substitute the values here now. So Q is equal to, see, charge is equal to I, current is how much? 0.5 ampere, and into, what is given here, next time? Time is how much? 600 seconds. 600 seconds. If you multiply this, how much do you get here? 0.5 into 600. After multiplication, you will get what? 300 coulomb. This is SI unit of charge. We are calculating charge here. So Q is what? 300 coulomb. We calculated what is asked already now. Charge was asked Q. So charge we have already calculated now. It is 300 coulomb. Now you see, let us come to know another example from the point of your exams. When we see they may change the data and they may ask something else. If you come to this, let us read the second problem. In second problem, you see, when a current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb, a charge of 300 coulomb flows through the circuit. Find the time duration for which the current is passed and express the time in minutes also. We can write here, just I have written till here. Okay, express the time in minutes, that also we can write. Now, when you read the second problem, you have to identify what is given again here. When a current of, current means again I, they have given. So, solution 2 here, second problem. Given, let us write here, what is given? Given is what? Here current again. Current is what? I. I, how much they have given? 0.5 ampere again, same ampere. Now, what is given next? See, charge it is given, you see. A charge of 300 coulomb flows through the circuit. Means charge also you need to write here first. See, what is charge? Charge is equal to, that is, charge is 300 coulomb. I wrote now. What is asked now? Next you see, charge 300 coulomb flows through the circuit. Find the time duration for which the current is passed. Means how long this current was passed through the circuit. That time we don't know. How long it was passed. So that time we need to calculate. See here, that is time. Time t is equal to what? It is asked. Okay. Now you see. Let us calculate here. As we know already, current, it is what? I is equal to Q by T. Right. Q by T, we know this already. What is asked here? Time is asked. So bring time to the left and bring this current to the right side. What it becomes, this formula now? Here, by exchanging the terms, this becomes T is equal to Q by I becomes. Right. Q by I. Now you see. Here, in place of Q, what you have to substitute this, that is 300 coulomb divided by, how much it is given, what current, it is 0.5 ampere, right, 0.5 ampere. Now you see, we have to calculate this. In order to calculate this, what we will do is, we will shift this point here to eliminate the decimal point, we will shift the point to the right side of 5 here. When you shift the point to the right side, here you will have to add one more zero, right. So this becomes how much? 3000 divided by 5. Now simplify this. 5 ones. Here 5 6 are. Right. Here 600 you are getting. 600. What is this? In seconds. Okay. We are getting this in seconds now. 600 seconds we got. Now what we have to do is, this 600 seconds, if you express this in minutes, what it becomes? This 600 seconds, if you divide it by minute, okay, minute means what? 1 minute means 60 seconds, right? So 600 divided by 60, if you do, 6 ones are, here also 6 ones are, 1 0 remains, here 10 it becomes, right? This is what? 10 minutes. You see, same we got or not, as it is again. So we can write here, time duration is, therefore, time duration t is equal to 10 minutes. We can write, you see. This is again our result here. Okay. What answer we got here? It is same. It applies to this problem also. Here it is asked something else. What it is asked here? Charge is asked. In this problem, what time is asked? Okay. But given data, they are everything same here. Now you see. When you read the data, here current was given, time was given. And in the next problem, current was given, charge was given. Here we calculated time. Here we calculated what? Charge. So, if you know this, you can solve any type of problems based on this. See, in the exam, here, in this formula, how many factors are there? 1, 2, 3 are there, right? Out of 3, 2 will be given, 1 will be asked. So, just by exchanging the terms here and there, just if you get that correct formula, in that substituting the values, you can get the right answer. So, this is the method of calculating the current, charge or time, okay, in a given problem there. So, you practice this and whatever the problems are given in exercise, you try to solve that so that you can understand still better way. Okay. And the problems based on potential difference we are going to see in the next video. Okay. I hope you understood this. If you understood the video, subscribe and share it to your friends. We'll meet again in the next video. Okay. Thank you.